You know, we it was a reception, and I was introduced to her, and we were chatting, and I said, you know, the first job I ever had during the war was covering your husband,
yeah.
King George VI. And I said, it's very nice now meeting the rest of the family.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
She laughed.
Yeah.
She has that merry laugh, you know, and she's the kind of a woman I think Diana's gonna grow into. You know,
yeah.
She's not intellectual. She doesn't read. She reads Sporting mm-hmm. Life, you know.
Yeah, and she loves Dynasty in Dallas,
she
right?
She loves horses. And not Diana, her grandmother.
Yeah.
And but they have the same kind of feeling for people on a one-to-one. Mm-hmm. I mean, Diana would pick up an old lady in a crowd and shake her hand and talk to her and tell her little family secrets. And she would go to a hospital and she'll sit at every bed and talk to each little girl or each little child in a bed on a one-to-one. She has that kind of sympathy and sensitivity.
Did you spend time with her? With Diane.
I chased around when they. I was in Venice when they came, and I chased around with them. And as a matter of fact, I talked to a young man who said, you know, he said Prince Charles came to my factory in Scotland. He said, and you know how these tours are. They're showcased. They're rehearsed. They even have the meal served in advance, and they know who speaks and when and who sits where. And he said. And Prince Charles looked at this tight schedule and said, I don't want to do all this.
Yeah.
I want to talk to the man who sweeps the floor.
Yeah.
He's a man who cares. He's a thoughtful man. And he's 13 years older than Diana. Remember,
yes.
She's just a kid of 24 now, you know.
Yeah.
And this is a whole new world, and some of it's boring. She said, it's 70% slog and 30% fantastic.
Yeah. You know? Okay, but Ralph, now let's talk about the first year of marriage is always the hardest.
Tough.
And the people who have left their employ and those who have, as we said, squealed.
Right. Well, I'll tell you, Alan Fisher has not squealed to anybody. He hasn't talked to a single person. He's a very loyal butler. He did quit. They had a big blow up. And although he didn't tell me this, he said to her, just because you come from a broken home, you're not going to break up my life, you know.
Yeah, demanding.
And she almost had a couple of nervous breakdowns, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's a hard adjustment. She, you know, her favorite phrase to her husband was, "Do I have to go?" She didn't want to go to a lot of these boring formal dinners. She liked informal parties where she danced a lot, you know. And they had, that's where their arguments were about attending these things. And he was sympathetic in a sense because he hated the boring dinners too, you know. But it had to be done. It had to be done, and it was a price of the job, you know. The Queen Mother said the price of the job and this is work.
Yeah, it's sort of be careful of what you want.
Right,
you may get it.
But she didn't make him into a wimp. Like a lot of these rumors and myths say. They're myths. Because, I mean, when they had an argument, you could hear him three blocks away, you know. And she didn't stop him from seeing his old friends. I talked to some of these old friends. They still see him, you know.
A lady Tryon. Yes.
Lady Tryon, who was supposed to be the one who was really dumped. Well, she told me I see them all the time at parties and balls. She says, in fact, I'm going to have a lunch with him tomorrow. She said, call me and I'll tell you how it comes out. And I called her and she said it was charming.
Yeah.
You know, the point was that those things are not true. She was not anorexic. I mean, she knew her husband liked slim blondes, that's all, and she wanted to stay slim, but she still packs away a meal, and it's vegetarian, of course.
Oh, really?
And he likes that vegetarian, too. Mm-hmm. She hasn't stopped him from hunting. He gave up hunting before he married her.
Okay, where did you get the marvelous pictures in this book, Ralph? Because I really should hold up some of them. They are
I'm so glad you like them, because
they're
spent a lot of time looking for them.
Yeah, so
I mean, that cover picture, for example.
Is wonderful.
The cover picture is, I found in a...
Picture of Diana with the Queen.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Well, you know, you look through hundreds of pictures, or thousands of pictures, and some of them just hit you.
Yeah.
And that was one that did. You know, it's a marvelous picture of the two of them, yes. You know, as a matter of fact, she lived in the palace for 4 months before they were married, you know. And she lived at one end of the floor, and he lived at the other end of the floor. British press never knew this.
Yeah.
She was supposed to be chaperoned with her grandmother.
Yeah.
But they lived for 4 months together in the same floor. Nobody else on that floor except for some servants tucked away in a corner.
Was she there, Charlie?
That's right. But the point is that in those 4 months, never once did the Queen invite her for lunch or dinner privately to say, well, this is what you're going to be faced with. It was strictly on-the-job training for Diana.
Yeah.
I mean, she learned to be a princess by being a princess.
Ralph, one last question. Did she ever really feel that pee under the 14 mattresses?
Well, I think she's learning
to
feel it. Yes. But there is magic.
Yeah.
There is magic.
Oh. absolutely. Yeah. Will you autograph my book?
I'll be delighted.
And we will be back after a short pause.